And welcome to this week's Dryland live stream. First of all, I got some cool news. I finally got the shirt that Thea and I have been creating and selling. I'm pretty excited, pretty happy about the results. I got all the different models, and I'll try and flash them in the videos from now on. And there's also a link in the description where you can go and order your own. This one is the Yoda shirt. This is low enough and there are. I think that would be appropriate for today's session. Because it's really all about getting low and making the legs burn. Today's going to be a whole lot of new exercises. I'm going to wait a little before I start explaining the exercises because some people are still checking in. I see we got 10 viewers now, so there's probably some more coming. I think usually we're about 30 or 40 live to these sessions. So I'll give a little moment. Today's all about getting low and staying low. It's really going to be, like I said in the description, I also advertised on Instagram about it. It is going to be a pure leg burner, KG. But it's going to be fun. It's going to be a new exercise, so that's going to be exciting. I'll do my best to try and explain and come with some technical tips. Hey, Nor. Meanwhile, let me know where you guys are from. I can see we got me. I'm Danish from Portugal. You can see Nor in Sweden. Headed. Hey, Sophia there. Oh, I got some cool news, Sophia. This is better than any super chat we've ever received before, just before this workout, because we've been doing it at the same location, she and I. One frequent viewer came by with two bottles of wine for us. So if you're listening, Sophia, we got wine. Vino. Pretty cool. That's got to be the best donation we had so far. But whoever that was, thanks a lot. And on the top of the wine, there was an apple pie to follow with it. I'm not sure I can share that with Sophia, because it's probably going to be bad by then. But that's pretty sweet. So we appreciate that. Cool. Where else are people from? Poland. Sophia from Russia. Nor from Sweden. Kedis from the Netherlands. Portugal, Denmark. Almost 10 countries so far. Nice. We haven't even started yet. So like I mentioned, today's going to be a combination of two different workouts. It's going to be pretty short, but it's going to be hard. There's going to be a lot of time imposition, a lot of working time, and not a lot of break time. I myself just did an inline skating workout, so I'm a little tired. It also explains why my hair looks like it's been under a helmet for 2 hours, because it has been under a helmet for 2 hours. So you got to deal with that, but I'm pretty sure we're not going to dig too far into aesthetics once we're halfway through the training session. It is cool. Hey, India. I would be surprised if there's no Indians here. So welcome to you. So like I said, for about 20 viewers, maybe it's time to go through today's training session. I want to let you know before we start, cool t-shirts that Thea and I make, you can click below and order them if you like. And don't forget to super chat if you like the content, and I promise to make more videos. Also subscribe because there is a video coming. There's a video coming every weekend from now on the channel, and it's going to be different technical exercises. Some of them are going to be what I call technique tips, just one single exercise explaining a drill to fix the technical problem that you probably didn't know you had. And then some of them are going to be complete workouts for a combination. It's usually an inline skate, which is a combination of 5 to 10 exercises that are either good for stability, mobility. Alright, I'll try and speak louder. I don't think it'll bother anybody nearby if I do, except for the birds. So I apologize for the bad sound, but, the volume is down by there, that explains it. And sorry if I blasted your ears for the rest of you. Anyway, time to get going. If you have any questions, just type them in. Thanks for the super chat, guys. First super chat coming in. All those super chats are really nice to receive, and that's what makes me able to do what I love, makes me able to skate, makes me able to make more of these live streams, more videos for the channel, so it's kind of like a way of coaching. So anything you donate to the channel, click on the super chat sign, a little dollar sign, and you can donate any amount you wish. Alright, so like I said, this workout is basically two workouts that follow each other. A lot of work time, and there's a lot of lactic acid that's going to build up. So first, that's why I said turn band, and wrote in the description, make sure you have a turn band. If you don't have a turn band, or a cable, elastic band, whatsoever, now's the time to try and find one. If you have an old seat belt, or basically anything that can hold your upper body and hold your weight as to do the exercise. Because the first exercise that we're going to do quite a lot of times, 10 times to be exact, is turn belt up down. So we're going to either put it around, I put it around my chest, or to some people, especially if you haven't done much core, you'd rather want it around your hips. Or if you want the workout to be extra hard in that way, you can put it around your hips. That allows you to get a little more tension, and that's just going to be harder for legs. On the other hand, it's a little closer related to inline skating or ice skating if you put it around here, the waist, because then you won't just let your upper body fall out of position, and you've got to keep everything together. Thanks for Super Chat, Nord. Nice to know you're watching. Hope you can use these workouts to share it with your club. And can't wait to come to you guys at the numbers. Thanks a lot for that. All right, so I'm going to do 35 seconds on each leg, a total of 5 times. And after the first 3, we're going to make a little break where I come back here and see if anybody has any questions. And just to make sure that everybody is on pace for what we're doing before we move on to the last 2 sets. So in total, it's going to be, we'll demonstrate, 35 seconds in one leg, 35 seconds in the other leg. 35 on one leg, 35 the other. 3 times, then a little rest, and then we do the same thing over 2 times. So that's going to take about 11 minutes, with the break a little longer. 6 minutes, with the break a little longer. Oh, if math is off before we start, I can't imagine by the end of this. The wind's blowing a little. Sorry about that. Hope you can still hear me. I'm looking at some microphones. I don't want to order it here in Portugal because I'm flying back to Denmark in a few days. So that would be dumb. So I'll get it shipped to my Danish address, and then hopefully we can have some better sound. For maybe already next week. That would be really sweet. Anyways, once we're done with the up-down, the first part of the workout, we're going to go back to something we're a little more familiar with. We're going to do 4 classic dry line exercises. I'll come back to those once we get there, because we're probably all going to forget. So we'll take that later on, but it's going to be 4 exercises, just 1 single set, but they're going to be hard. It's going to be 2 minutes of actual working time and then just 1 minute of rest. So for this, 35 seconds, one leg, 35 the other, 35 back, 35 the other, there's no rest in between until we've done each leg 3 times, and we take a little set rest, and then both legs twice, come back here, and we wait until we catch our breath, and then we go for the 4 dry line exercises, just a single set. So in total, from now on, it should all take about 20-25 minutes. So it's not that long, but it's very effective, and there's more time for working than when we're resting. I think the total rest time is like 8 minutes for the full workout. So it's going to be hard, but it's going to be fun. And the whole reason we do this is so that we can get in shape, and it's going to make skating on actual skates a lot easier. That's also going to be the video. I can reveal that now. The video I'll be posting this weekend is about how you can train skating anywhere. So for anybody, anywhere, anytime, basically inline skating exercises where you're not going anywhere. But trust me, those are not to be underestimated, because a lot of inline skating is balance, coordination, and just feeling comfortable on your skate. Anyway, if there's any questions, now is the time. If you don't have a band, turn band like I do, you can do the classic one leg squat. It's gonna be really hard to come to that. One leg up down, same leg for 35 seconds, and then switch leg. I'm gonna do the turn band. It's gonna be a little closer to the actual proper skating. Yeah, it's a really good way to get a little more out of the leg. You're not gonna be technically limited to where you are when you're skating. Give you a little more time to really start your try to get the camera a little closer. You guys can see what I'm doing. Trying to imitate a little. Thank you. if you're all ready to start out in 10 seconds, so get your band, your elastic, get ready, I'm going to start with my 5X, and just right here, cover together. The bird's getting mad at me. They have no idea how free to like that. Cozy here, you're made for life. Penguin boy. Fancy nickname you got there. Where to keep the belt? It's really individual. It depends on what you want to work on. I think if this is the first time you ever do anything with a corner band, a belt, or elastic, I would keep it around the hips because it's simply easier to get it correct, technically speaking. Whereas if you put it, like I did here, around the waist, there's a bigger chance of making some of those small mistakes. So put it around the hips. If you want to especially if you do it as a continuous turn band with a partner, or just, you know, you cross over and somebody's holding your back, you can consider putting it down the hip against if it's too easy. So technically it's harder in the chest. Physically it can be harder when it's around the hip. Just because you're limited by how strong your core are and how much you can withhold. So that really comes down to where you are and what you want to work at. But just play around with it. I usually do turn handband or corner belt warm up, where I do some on the hip, some around the chest, where there's weight to the chest. Sometimes I do it with my hands on my back, sometimes I use one arm, hold the band. It's really cool because there's so many variations, which is nice in that way. But can also be a little confusing, I get that. Let's not keep too much of a rest here. We're going to get pretty leg burn. Last is below the waist, before we get into the driving, so we can work on that capacity to still look good. Second, while we're doing our driving, while we're skating and switching. So I'm going to get back to myself. Do it slowly, just keep while doing it. Oh, Sophia, I like how super chats make you happen. You got wine, super chat, full life. Amazing, Sophia. All right, the burn healing, it's new, but I don't hear so well. Usually it's nice for the bird to like sing like that for sure, but when trying to do dry land and explain how you do it, it's a little annoying. I'll bring you guys with me over here. Thank you.
make me feel a little better about it. But, thank you.
Will there be exercise to increase speed? Somebody asked.
that can increase the speed. It's going to take a while because you're not explosive exercise. It's more about balance and feeling a little more comfortable with making decisions. But I believe that the stronger you are, the harder you can work in training, the more sessions you can get in a week. So that way it's going to help you get faster as well if you do this as a pre-session before your strength workout. Just to get more fit. The fitter you are, the harder you can work. But these exercises won't directly make you faster sprint-wise. They're going to give you a lot of muscle endurance, but in terms of skills to sprint really fast, this might not be the perfect workout. There's a lot of those in the channel, and if you go back, there's also some of the dry lines that are explosive exercises. Some of those which you see here, the one where you eight jumps with, I think, 15 seconds on and 45 off. That's really nice. The main difference between what makes you faster and what makes you stronger is that to get faster, you do all the exercises as hard as you can. And they're going to be a lot shorter, but it tends to be in the sky. So much more rest. Don't get too exhausted because then you lose the capacity to really give your all and develop those fast twitch muscle fibers and work the technique. So yeah, weightlifting can also make you stronger. I talked about weightlifting in the last skating lessons, so scroll just one video back on the channel so you can see that. That's also an option. But now you have explosive exercises. Look through my channel, there's a lot of videos on this. I've done a lot of dry run videos previously, also non-live videos. But for the future, it's going to be more about some exercises on skate. Those are hard to do live. I haven't really figured a way to do that yet, but until then, there's a lot of those on the channel as well. So they'll be uploaded every week from now on. Just hit the subscribe and you'll get notified about that. Hey, Pasha, I wasn't sure if you were with us today, Pasha. Thanks, appreciate it. Pasha is one of the guys that's been here for quite a while. I don't know how long, but he must be pretty strong by now. He has some well-developed quads and glutes because he's been here for a lot of sessions and he's done a really good job. If I remember correctly, he had some pretty solid heart rate for some of them. So thumbs up for that. That's pretty cool. Yep. Cool to have you as well. Nice that we have so many viewers coming back. That's nice to see. Yeah, make it a little more fun. I look forward to the next time. Wednesday skating lesson. Unless we get a better topic, it's going to be about what shoes and shoe wear to wear for the different dry lines and off days and workouts in general. I don't give a skate. I'm just looking at that. Like one food I would bring in with people. We did make or did make one lesson about how to improve the transfer to fitness gauge, speed gauge. Diet, yeah. That would be a fun topic. That's what I do. I aim to study for finishing my bachelor in health and nutrition. So that's something I find pretty interesting. Just often know something about that could be a super good topic as well. Thanks for suggesting that. That's all for now. I say thanks to all of you for being part of this workout, and thanks to those of you that super chatted. That'll be nice. The microphone is going to happen. And make sure you get a cool shirt. You can get one that's not as pretty as mine, but get a Yoda shirt, low enough you never are. And lots of other cool shirts. They're in the description below, or in the store, on the YouTube channel. So you can pass that. And they're free. Until next time, if you have any comments, questions, I'll make sure to answer after this is uploaded. My quads and glutes are stronger. Nice. See y'all, and stay fit, stay safe.